name's Connor, and I'm the CEO of Molly's Co. But basically, today I just wanted to spend like 10 minutes telling you how easy it is to start whatever you want online. So using like the previous knowledge that I gained from Mr. Connor's class, you'll learn how to make the 2D graphics. And like this graphic right here, it took me 10 minutes to make this. And I was able to incorporate this image on one of my first products. But in this age that we're in, you can basically share whatever you want with everybody in the world. For me, I used Instagram. So in my first year of college, I pledged a fraternity, and that was great and all, but I decided I wanted a hamster out of the blue. So I went to Petco and spent $20 on a hamster. My friend's named her Molly, and if you go over to What's With the Hamster, just scroll down to some pictures, people from all over campus just love this hamster, and basically came over just to take pictures, scroll all the way down, just to take pictures of the hamster. They're absolutely obsessed. Keep going. Yeah. So what I would do is just, feature my friends with the hamster, and it's just like for fun games. And someone out of the blue was like, "Oh, you should make a company off of this." So I was like, "Okay, I'll make a hamster company." But using this idea, like the thing is, people nowadays, they create these weird ideas, and a lot of people are gonna tell you, "Oh, that's stupid. Like, don't waste your time with that." So many people told me that, but I went ahead and just started making my own designs, and believe it or not, this whole thing is so simple. You can use this online company called Printful, which basically allows you to pick your graphics on any of their products. So you can do beach blankets, long sleeves, t-shirts, sweatshirts, hats. I was able to make a whole section for each one of these, and combine that with an e-commerce website called Shopify. So it's kind of similar to probably how you present your project.
Sure. Connor, do you mind if I just ask you, because I think at the heart of the matter is, the kind of driving force and what the hamster means to you. So I just certainly let's show some merchandise, but what has Molly kind of become? What is this brand about?
So even though I my initial interest, like the spark by just how everybody loved the hamster, I also noticed that like everybody loves hamsters. Like these people would come over and just completely leave just so happy. I absolutely love that. And for me personally, I struggled with a lot of mental health issues in the past, and I wanted to kind of speak out about that. And using this website, I wanted to promote mental health awareness by donating 20% of each of the net profit towards NAMI, which is the largest national organization on mental health awareness. So tying that in with the hamster and how everybody loves hamsters and just sparks pure happiness. So you want to create this environment where everybody just feels, welcome. Because the best thing for people is just that they know that people are there for you, and nobody's struggling alone. So that's the whole backbone to this entire thing. And using that, I was able to just promote that Instagram account that I made a while ago and transform it into this business account. So a lot of my artwork is just inspired off of Molly. So like this one I made last night, and that one's just Molly's Co. by Hamsters for Hamsters in collaboration with Molly the Hamster. But if you scroll down, like there's so many basically just 2D vector art, and you can incorporate that with any of the products offered by Printful, and you can just change the colors and etc. Set your own prices.
Sure, it's amazing. And did they tie dye them for you, or
so,
how's that work?
So these ones are easier because you can just incorporate your logo on the front side or the back side of that t-shirt, and they give you like this much space. But for these tie dye ones, you'll notice that they're much more expensive than those simple ones. And that's because I had to use Photoshop plus Illustrator to create like these, where the shirt's not actually tie dye, it's really just an image put onto the entire canvas of the t-shirt, and that's why it costs more resources to do that.
It's like you got sweatshirts and long sleeves as well.
Yep. All this whole thing is so, so simple. And really, if anyone has like an idea, just, you know, just give it a shot, and you can seriously do whatever you want, especially with all these resources today, especially like Instagram. It's so simple.
How long did it kind of take you to kind of get things up and running? Was this sort of like a little bit at a time over the course of a year, or is it like a few real late night sessions, really just kind of, or a little bit of both?
I mean, I usually stay up till like 4 a.m. like drinking coffee and doing this. I can't sleep. Like this summer, I don't have a job, so until like next week, so I spend my free time doing this. And like last night, I also introduced the stickers, and I already got a few sales on that. But the whole thing, the hardest part is definitely just using the platform. Shopify is kind of annoying, and Printful is easy. Printful makes the whole thing automatic. So one of the biggest things about this is that you might have like noticed there's a lot of advertisers on Instagram, and they advertise their products just like me. But a lot of these people, like they use printing companies and get their product shipped to their house. And once at their house, they have like 50 t-shirts, and they have to sell all of them to each customer. The special thing about using Printful in collaboration with Shopify is that the whole thing's automatic. So actually, I don't own any of these products. This is the only thing I have in person right now. That's just to save myself money. But when somebody orders the product, they'll just click on it, add to the cart, and buy it. I get the money directly. And then I myself have to order, it does it automatically, but it sends that information to the printing company, and the printing company sends it to the customer. So I don't have to do anything, I just sit back and just make more designs. So that's why I'm probably able to do so much.
Wow, and you also don't have to worry about, you know, it's that you know, that really careful calculation of, can I actually, if I make these, can I stock them, do I sell them, what if I don't sell them, I put all this money down, and so... do they do, for folks interested in making books and other types of publications?
Yeah.
Because that's same thing with books. I mean, it used to be with t-shirts, it's like, well, yeah, you can afford to do it if you make 500 of them, but is increasingly this sort of, kind of small production becoming small production and portal technology making it so that, folks want to just buy or make an individual book for themselves, that it's much more affordable, and you can kind of sell, for example, if you did a publication of a book, you could do it this way, or?
Well, yeah, because I do it this way, the only thing I have to pay for is running the site, and running the site costs $30 a month, plus 14 if you want a custom domain like what I have, but because I just have to make the designs, it's really mostly about time as opposed to money. I don't have to invest anything into all these products, since they're all digital.
And what do you find are your best like sort of marketing venues so far, like just for spreading awareness about the product? Is it mostly online or just person to person?
Yeah, so you have to use social media nowadays. I went to Nashua a few days ago, running around to like Marshalls and like Eastern Border to see if they would consider stocking my clothing in their stores. But unfortunately, they're just so big and they can't invest too much money in small businesses. So the best thing you can do right now is simply use Instagram or Facebook or Twitter. I just find Instagram to be easiest. I was able to use my previous audience from the fan page that I made a while ago to transform it into this.
And then, Connor, real fast, one thing we're always curious to hear about from like alumni is like, because you're in school for engineering, right?
Yeah, so I have nothing to really do with any of this digital art stuff. It's really just a hobby.
Okay.
But clearly, it's worked out for me, and so many people doubted me at the beginning, so it's kind of funny. But if you have an idea, just go for it. If you have free time, just go for it.
Nice. So hopefully, folks, since we're working on websites right now, and with photography, for example, self promotion or promotion of an idea, a business, something you care about. I think increasingly easy to do, increasingly attractive kind of options for doing that, and then plenty of forums to kind of share it on, and so that's kind of a nice zero to 60 really.
But the biggest thing is you have to be passionate about what you're doing. Otherwise, when failure hits you, you might give up. So I was passionate about this because it's towards mental health awareness, and that's allowed me to pull designers just making designs, just because I genuinely enjoyed it. So yeah, make sure you just find something that you actually like doing.
Sure, sounds good. And I guess what we'll try to do, and I just have to kind of run by admin, you know, just because I don't know if we can do kind of direct, you know, sort of transactions. But if folks, I mean, personally, I'm definitely gonna buy it. I love these T-shirts. So I'd love to grab one, and people might want to, at some point, you know, like check out your site or kind of approach you. What's the easiest way to kind of remember to get back there? Just Google Molly's Co. or what?
I was gonna bring in some cards, but my printer wasn't working today. So you can seriously just go on Instagram and Google, or Google is Molly's Co. and it should pop up.
Okay. Yeah. So seems like a great gift, great piece. Any questions you guys have for Connor?
So that was a little tough for me. I mean, one of the biggest backbones behind all this is I want to make it as affordable as possible. So if you go to the T-shirts, I think the simple ones like this one are only $16. And I'll tell you guys, I only make $5 a profit for that, which is like a dollar towards NAMI, which it really isn't too much. But the fact that more people can afford these and buy them without feeling like they're spending a ton of money is what I was going for. So it's depending on how you want to take it. Do you want to sell this a smaller number at a greater profit margin, or, you know, try to sell more in quantity? And because I'm aiming for Instagram and a ton of followers, then I want to go for quantity. And also the T-shirt business makes, I think there's a 4% to 14% profit margin, which this is perfectly in the range for that, but on the cheaper side, of course. But yeah, I kind of did all that out myself, and it's pretty simple to figure out how much your customer is paying. I would just test it. I would just order my own shirt and see how much it would cost me. You can incorporate extra charges on the shipping. Like, you're in charge of all the shipping, the taxes, everything on this website. But you essentially have to order your own T-shirt using Printful, and that's how much how much you have to spend in comparison to how much other people are spending. So it's really not as complicated as you think. And a lot of other things is that this website, it probably scares a lot of people, like, you know, how do you make a website? And the whole Shopify is the biggest e-commerce website online right now. And it gives you your own theme. You can choose from multiple themes, and you can just add your product, and it does this all for you. You don't have to program or code any of this. So don't be scared. Try this out.
Yeah, it's pretty clean and mean, I have to say. Very nice.
Any other questions?
Okay, maybe we end our video and